Hello everyone, I'm so happy to meet you all through this video. It's been for 6th week and this is my first update in English regarding Lent days. Jesus is a God of hope. This is my topic today I'm going to talk on. Right now, the entire world is searching on hope. If we ask this question to someone, what is hope? They can say, my hope is on my family. Someone can say that, my hope is on my education, my studies, my career, my profession. Or somebody can say that my hope is on my husband, on my wife, or on my children. Or somebody can say on the relatives too. And differently, somebody can say, I don't have any hope. Actually, I would like to take from their example, because definitely they can say the true only. They may not have hope on their life, but their life is hope, because life is hope. That hope comes from God. I would like to quote here the word hope from the scripture. Romans chapter 15 verse 13 says, may the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that by the power of the Holy Spirit you may abound in hope. Yes, my dear friends, there is a hope for us. You may not have a hope on you, but Jesus is very serious about you. Again, I just want to tell you that you may not have hope on you or on your life, but Jesus is very serious about each and everyone's life. If you go through the New Testaments, most of the miracle of Jesus Christ, you can see he did miracles when the people were in difficult situation. Wherever he did the miracles, you can see very clearly that the circumstances of the people were so hopeless cases. I can say many examples from the New Testament itself. Number one, you can go through the chapter Mark chapter 10 verse 46 to 52. Jesus heals the blind man for the Bartimaeus. He was a beggar. He was a blind man. What was his nature of what? Begging and having the food, whatever he had. He was in a hopeless situation. Nobody was there to help him. But a fine day came. Jesus entered the life of Bartimaeus. He gave him a vision. His life completely changed from blindness to vision. And second example from John chapter 11 verses 18 onwards. You all know the familiar name Lazarus. He was a friend of Jesus. He had two sisters. What happened? He died because of the sickness. He had been entombed for 4 days. His sisters were so desperate. There was hopeless cases and hopeless situations. Everything was got over in his life. But what happened? Exactly, Jesus entered the life of him and he had shown the light of hope on the life of Lazarus. He raised Lazarus from the death. What a mighty miracle happened there. Death to life. And next example I can say from. In Matthew chapter 8 verse 1 to 4 says that Jesus heals a man with leprosy. You just think about the man with leprosy. Nobody was ready to touch him. He was condemned and excluded by the society. But Jesus entered and healed him. His life was hopeless situation, hopeless circumstances, because he was living an abnormal life. Nobody was ready to touch him too. But after the arrival of Jesus Christ, his life was completely changed from abnormal to normal. What a wonderful time, what a miracle life he had on the particular day. Finally, I would like to say example from John chapter 8 verse 1 to 11. A woman who was caught in the act of adultery. So what will be the next moment? She has to die according to the law of Moses. Everyone was thinking like that. Even she also was thinking like that only. But really what happened? Jesus entered and had shown the light of hope on the life of her. He forgave her. What happened next? She completely changed her life and she started to follow Jesus earnestly. Jesus gave a great gift to her. After the resurrection of Jesus, she is the woman who saw Jesus at first. She is none other than Mary Magdalene.
Here, I would like to conclude by asking a few more questions. Have you lost your confidence? Have you come with broken spirit or broken heart? Never give up, my dear friends. Jesus will help you in all the situations. Because Proverbs 23:18 says, there is surely a future hope for you, and your hope will not be cut off. Again, I want to encourage you, your hope will not be cut off, because Bible says very clearly, if you have faith with Jesus, definitely He will come for your aid. As a Christian, why should we have hope? Because Jeremiah chapter 29:11 says, for I know the plans I have for you, declare the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. So again and again, the words insisting that you will have a hope. Here, I want to encourage you by saying a few more words. There is no such things as hopeless as long as God is in His throne. Because nowadays I can see people are desperate. They are searching on something which they don't get it. But they forget that there is a God who is very serious about them. You can name it any issues, any problem or any diseases. But my Jesus is more than a conqueror. Don't worry about anything. Just think that our God is a healer. Everything else disappoints you, but Jesus will never ever disappoint you. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for the wonderful day that you've given to us, Lord. Thank you for being a God of hope. And I pray for the people, those who are watching and joining me here in the prayer, Lord. Lord, I pray for each and every one, those who are having any issues, Lord. You please help them to come out of all those issues they have. Lord, also I pray for the coronavirus. Lord, you are greater than any disease in the world, Lord. According to your promise, we pray, Lord. Lord, I praise you. I love you so much because you are the God who loves us unconditionally, Lord. Everything I submit your mighty hand. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Thank you so much for watching this. I'll see you all next week. Bye-bye.